Last week, the Inspector of Government, Betty Kamya, cleared the former NSSF boss, Richard Byarugaba, of the 15 corruption-related offences brought against him by the Gender Minister, Betty Amongi. In the report released, Betty Kamya noted that there was no evidence to incriminate Byarugaba with acts of abuse of office, corruption, and embezzlement of public funds. She, however, ordered him to refund about 5 billion shillings.
I'm going to now write to Mr. Byarugaba and Mr. Mwanje, asking them to refund the money.
However, civil society organizations believe this is merely an act of glorifying the implicated officer.
You can't say that there was no fault, but please pay 4.5 billion shillings back. It just does not up. There was no impropriety, and then all of a sudden he said that, but refund. What are you refunding if there was no impropriety?
Also, over a week ago, the Director of Public Prosecutions, Jane Abodo, closed 17 files in respect to the government officials implicated in the Iron Sheet saga. The officials are believed to include the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, Vice President Jessica Alupo, Prime Minister Robin Nabanja, among other ministers. Ejoyi, however, believes this was wrong and recommends that at least a political action be taken against these officials.
PP may have dropped cases, but the political cases have not been dropped. We're still expecting, and I hope that His Excellency will still stand up for what he said, that there's political corruption, and take political action. He does not owe anything to the ministers to keep them in office if he knows they're politically indulged in corruption. And then there are other dimensions. Corruption is also a moral issue.
Every year, Uganda loses close to 9.14 trillion shillings to corruption, according to the IGG report of 2022. To counter this scourge, CSOs are championing this year's National Citizens Integrity Awards, set to take place on the 11th of July, which is the African Anti-Corruption Day. The awards seek to promote the fight against corruption by recognizing public officials who demonstrate high levels of integrity when serving communities. Members of the public have been urged to nominate officials they deem eligible for these awards.
We call upon citizens to actively participate in nominating these public officials of integrity by providing the details of these nominees who meet the above criteria as already described. The awards are also undertaken annually. Every year we organize these awards, so citizens are encouraged to look out every year for people who meet the criteria, as already mentioned.
This particular award is aimed at to safeguard the integrity integrity awards from potential conflict of interest and due influence following the categories of people excluded from participating in the process as awardees, and will be disqualified if their names are submitted for consideration.
Let's see Ugandans who are in public service, who are diligently serving the communities, and they're delivering the public goods. Let's recognize them. Let's say this is the way to go.
Rachel Nachuala reporting for the news.